Hi, my name is Vanessa Hill. I create this channel, BrainCraft, and for a second, I want you to imagine you're me.
Oh, wow. That's too close.
I'm really interested in sleep, and I've made a bunch of videos on sleep science, health, and food. I live in New York City, I have a master's degree, and occasionally my mind wanders and I think about getting a PhD. I've actually Googled doing this at Columbia many times. And here's where it gets weird.
So I started getting Google alerts for another Vanessa Hill, a science PhD student at Columbia who is researching sleep. We even have the same middle name. So to make things weirder, I reached out to her because she recently published a paper on how sleep can have antioxidant benefits. So you'll never guess who we're going to meet.
So this is the market.
Vanessa?
Hi.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you? Hey,
thank you for letting us come into your life.
Yeah,
this is very weird.
It's a little strange.
And this is the other Vanessa M. Hill, who finished her PhD at Columbia earlier this year. Apart from being named twins, I really wanted to meet her because her work seems fascinating. She researched sleep, setting out to determine why do we sleep?
So that really is the million-dollar question.
And it's a question that we still can't really answer, which is nuts considering we spend about a third of our lives asleep.
And if you think about it, it's a pretty bizarre behavior, right? Because when an animal is sleeping, it's totally vulnerable, it's exposed. You wouldn't think that that would be necessarily beneficial to the animal.
Mm-hmm.
And so that suggests that sleep must fulfill something, some process that's so fundamental to mm-hmm. animal life that it has evolved in all these different animal species.
Right now, we do know that sleep plays a crucial role in learning and memory. But that still doesn't explain why we sleep.
We don't know whether we needed learning and memory, and that's why sleep evolved. That's, you know, that was the pushing force behind this evolution of sleep behavior.
Mm-hmm.
Or did sleep evolve for some other reason, and learning and memory were conveniently, placed into that mm-hmm. sleep state time.
Mm-hmm. The other thing that learning and memory doesn't explain is the link between less sleep and health issues.
There's a huge amount of correlational evidence that people who are chronically sleep restricted, meaning that they sleep less than 6 hours per night,
mm-hmm.
They tend to develop diseases like diabetes, heart disease, obesity, Alzheimer's more often than the average person.
It suggests that sleep has a role in our overall health.
There's this idea that there might be some underlying core function of sleep on the cellular level.
So Vanessa actually used fruit flies that are short sleepers as a model to study sleep.
And so I thought, of course, flies that don't sleep enough, they'll be sick. And you know, that I'll get out of here quickly with my PhD and be on my way. And it took actually a few years that they didn't really have an immunity defect, or not in the way that I expected.
Well, that's more interesting in a way.
It was very interesting.
What Vanessa eventually found was that sleep has antioxidant benefits. But to understand how, first we need to define what are antioxidants. You've probably seen health food commercials like this one, where a Cyclops antioxidant hammers free radicals.
Humongous, hulking free radical hammering. Antioxidants.
As well as antioxidants, you hear this term free radicals all the time.
Free radicals, free radicals, free radicals.
So free radicals are molecules that are natural byproducts of energy. And in biology, free radicals have another name, a three-letter acronym, which we're going to need to remember for the next minute or so.
Most of these molecules that are free radicals, most of them are oxygen containing. So we actually call them more often in biology reactive oxygen species.
Okay.
They will react with our proteins, our lipids, our DNA, and our body and sort of wreak havoc in a cell.
Now these free radicals or reactive oxygen species wreak havoc because they have a chemical imbalance.
The antioxidants in our body are there to essentially neutralize reactive oxygen species. That's why we need antioxidants, because antioxidants are very good at donating electrons to these greedy reactive oxygen species that are going around trying to rip electrons from wherever they can find.
So what happens if we have too many of these in our body?
Yeah, so if we have too many reactive oxygen species in our body, then what happens is that it will cause what's called oxidative damage.
Oxidative damage can eventually lead to death in people or flies. Had you forgotten about the short sleeping fruit flies? When Vanessa gave them a substance containing more reactive oxygen species, they died.
That told me that they had perhaps a buildup of reactive oxygen species in their body.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's sort of how we got to our eventual conclusion that sleep might serve some antioxidant function in the brain.
And there is one more question to ask of the flies. If they sleep more, do they have better antioxidant function?
And so we answered that question by inducing sleep in fruit flies. These flies that slept more than usual were actually resistant to oxidative stress, which suggests that they had perhaps fewer reactive oxygen species or better antioxidant activity.
Now, it's important to maintain a balance between free radicals and antioxidants. And Vanessa's findings support a theory by this scientist Raymond in the 90s that free radicals accumulate in the brain while we're awake and sleep allows for them to clear.
So there's this buildup of ROS in the brain while we're awake, and this man hypothesized that perhaps sleep provides an opportunity when our brain is not as active for the brain to clear out those reactive oxygen species before we enter a state of oxidative stress. Recently, there's been a lot of good evidence published that suggests that during sleep, there is a greater flow of cerebral spinal fluid in the brain that helps to flush out toxins. And so we know that it helps to flush out protein buildup in the brain. And so it's very possible that it also helps to flush out any accumulation of ROS.
Now, just in case you'd forgotten about the
free radical annihilating antioxidants,
the last thing I want to know is, what's the deal with antioxidant-rich food?
I brought you some high in antioxidant juice.
Oh.
Is this better than sleep?
So, no. That's the short answer. But people seem to think that we get antioxidants from food, and we do. And I don't want to burst the antioxidant bubble here.
Because you can. You're qualified, I think.
You know, it's great to have a balanced diet with foods that are rich in antioxidants. But the majority of the antioxidants that our body relies on to neutralize reactive oxygen species, we produce them naturally within our own bodies.
I guess you can lay off the $8 juices.
Supplementing antioxidants is not going to replace sleep.
So, all in all, one Vanessa M. Hill, PhD, did 7 years of research to discover that sleep has antioxidant benefits. And then, after months of Google alerts and a day of hanging out, another Vanessa M. Hill swooped in and made this video for you to reinforce that sleep is super duper important, and maybe right now, you should go and catch some shut-eye.
Some people on Twitter had some questions for you, like, had you seen BrainCraft before I emailed you?
Oh, okay. So I have to admit that I hadn't seen BrainCraft, but I did find you on, I did find Nessie Hill on Twitter.
On Twitter,
I did. I did know you were on Twitter, but I had not found BrainCraft.
Have you subscribed since I reached out?
I certainly will be.
So not yet, but
not
soon.
Yet. But soon, of course.
Okay.
Of course.
Do you have a dog? That was another question.
I have a cat. Yeah.
Okay. What's your cat's name?
My cat's name is Penny.
Oh,
shout
that's
out
really,
to Penny.
Yeah. Okay.
She'll be really excited.
Yeah.
I have one more announcement, which is that PBS Digital Studios has a couple of new shows. One is called America from Scratch, and it imagines what America would look like if it was started today rather than 250 years ago. And the other one is called Nourish, which is a show about food from a rocket scientist and whole hog barbecue pit master. They're both really cool, and we would super appreciate it if you would check them out. I'll paste the links here in the videos. We'll be here. Thanks.